How you doing, guys? So it's been a couple weeks since I made a video, which is a lot better than it was in the past. Got a lot done this video session, and the trailer, like I say, every video is really coming along. I got the bathroom framed, I got some countertop work done, I got this entertainment center pretty much fully framed out, and I just need to buy some plywood or some siding to put up over the insulation to kind of close in this place and actually make it have permanent walls. I've been having a lot of fun. It's been a lot of non-difficult as far as manual labor work. It's a lot of measuring and screwing stuff in. It's been a real learning process for me, so I'm enjoying it a lot. And I hope you guys are still enjoying it. I'm gonna put the videos and pictures of that coming up. See you later. Hello friends. So in the last video, if you guys watched it, I made these countertops here. It's at least the rough frame. And as you can see here, I finished the top of it. So what I did is I took some of the flooring, obviously, that you see down here. And I had extra pieces, and I was debating on putting some countertops that I reclaimed from the garbage on there. I decided not to do that for more than one reason, one of them being I stored them in the garage, and I think some moisture got into the, it's like a particle board, compressed sawdust kind of countertop with like a laminate piece on top of that. It got some mold on it, and I also realized that it was like an inch thick and a lot of extra weight for no reason. So I thought this would be a cool idea. It looks really nice. It is a little bumpy, I will admit. My craftsmanship is getting better, but still run into some problems here and there, so slight bumpiness, but I'm gonna figure out a solution for that, or just keep it. I kinda like that rustic look. So I also finished this cabinet here, which is kinda cool. Let me see if I can actually open it with a view. So, opens pretty well, see on the back there. I have no idea, or I had kind of an idea of what I was doing, but I've never done this before, so it's all kind of just winging it. And shuts nice and good. Those are pallet boards, stained. I think it looks really cool. Haven't quite got to this yet. That's gonna be probably the next video, as well as that top. Finished this. These were some reclaimed tiles that I mentioned before. I also have them down here. I also have some over here and here. They're coming really handy. Non-rotting, real heavy duty and waterproof, stain resistant. Like I said, I did this here. So the plan with this area is, I mentioned in the last video, I'm going to be doing a sink of sorts here. I'm still looking for you know, the materials for that. Down here will be the exit for the piping and some storage. And oh, well, I'm over here, might as well mention this. I also did another door out of pallets. Check that out. Pretty cool. And let me swing around. So yeah, that's that corner. More of this tile stuff. I also did this, which is getting kind of hard to see. Let me move over here, guys. All right, so this entertainment center is pretty much framed. I still need to put up, you know, the walls and the flat surfaces here. I'm gonna have, probably, I haven't completely figured out what I'm gonna store here, but I like to have like either a opening here with a door on it, or do a bookshelf. I might do the bookshelf here or in here. And then I wanna have like a projector up here that will come down instead of putting a TV. I might do a TV wall mounted here, but I think I'm gonna do the projector. I like the idea of it being able to roll up. So that's pretty much all finished-ish. And it's looking really nice. So let's pan over here. I finally, which I said I was gonna do in the last umpteen videos, finished the, except for this little piece, don't judge me, the ceiling. And I just need to, you know, kind of touch it up a little bit, but it's looking really nice. I'm glad I went with the pallets. A lot of extra weight, but you know what? Whatever. It looks good. I'm happy with it. And like I said before, I'm not going to be moving this too often. So bathroom next. As you can see, I framed the bathroom. Again, I've never done this before. I did some really interesting cuts that I've not done before either. I don't know if you can see that there. Not the best job, but I'm happy with it. So I kind of did a cut here and then a cut this way. And it's super, super stable. Hoping that the movement of the trailer doesn't break any of these seams or test the structural integrity of this structure. So yeah, that's going to be the bathroom in here. I'm going to have some storage right here, and then I'm going to figure out some type of system where I have you know, a water reservoir and then a pump. I've seen 12-volt water pumps in there, and I probably will have a door from this side down here, and then I'll have a, you know, a door here and down here, and then some access from this way inside of the shower bathroom area. I still need a shower basin. I'm looking for that. So that's gonna be, you know, next on my list of things to get. So I'm gonna think about doing the shower basin here, and then a composting toilet right here. The door will open this way, and I'm still kind of figuring out how to make that happen, but given my successful building so far, I know I'll figure it out.
Like a glove.
Hey guys, so right now I'm working on getting this bottom area insulated underneath the countertops on both sides. As I mentioned before in a previous clip, I'm putting a sink up top here. And I'm gonna have down here a little water area as far as piping coming down and or holding water. And then on the other side I'm doing an electrical box, which is no longer visible from the inside. I'm gonna do probably 2 inches of foam on that. It's not gonna be a highly drafty area, given there is gonna be a, let me show you here, a door on the outside, which I built but didn't hinge yet. And that should, also I'm gonna have these doors, you know, closed most of the time, or at least at night. That will prevent drafting coming through, so I think 2 should do it on that area. And I'll show you the progress, guys. See ya. So what I'm doing here is basically measuring out the insulation for underneath the countertops, and I'm using, instead of a blade, a scraper. Let me see if I can find it here. Here it is. Sorry, guys. This right here. I'm using this. I sharpened this corner here with a file, and it's just nice and sharp, and I like the handle too. It's nice for gripping, and you just kind of measure it out, slide it along there, and it cuts like butter. Hello, friends. So right here, I have half the trailer closed. It's raining out pretty bad. I just took a little break, so I'm gonna show you this. Basically right here, I last video I had put some insulation on the bottom here, and I put wood planks all the way across. This right here, I built a door that will be accessible from the outside that will bring me into the electrical box. And this wood goes all the way over to this side where there's another opening here I'm gonna build a door for. I also framed up some of this up top here. I'm gonna have some pictures in a second to show you that. And I'm liking the way it looks. I think I'm gonna do these boards all on the outside here, all the way across. There's gonna be probably a little window here as well as here. I like the wood look, and it's gonna be an easy thing to seal it up with. Hey guys, so the last 2 days or so I've been working on finishing up some odd jobs. Let me swing around and show you what I've been working on. Alright, so where we are right now is the Murphy bed area. I recently came into a bunch of pallets, like 9 of them. I took them all apart the last few days, and I decided to, instead of using plywood here, I would do these pallets. I really like the look of it. Kind of looks like a barn look. I did that look in another spot also. So basically I just, you know, stack these boards up and then use brad nails to secure them. I still need to get one more board. I'm using really thin slats for this to keep the weight down, and just because I don't need to do the thick ones. I also, over here, I had the same issue with contemplation of using the plywood. I couldn't find any plywood that was the soy-based non-VOC glue under a inch or 3/4 of an inch. And it was like nearly $40 a sheet and really heavy. So I decided to improvise, and I made, pallets as the wall. I may get a small piece of plywood there. I haven't decided yet what I'm going to do there. And there's going to be a shelf right up top here. So, yeah, just it's pretty self-explanatory. Just took the pallets, put them upright, took a pallet, cut it in half, used a spec screw, it's like a tapping screw, into the wall through the insulation into the plywood. And then down here, I decided this is still rough. Get this out of the way. Just pallets. And I'm going to sand these down and stain them. I kind of like the look of it. I just cut a couple pieces for the trim also, all the way on the side. I did the same thing over here, or next to the entertainment center area. Again, just, you know, pallet boards up and spec screws into the wall. Up here, I may be putting a heating unit. I haven't quite decided yet, 50-50 on that, if I'm going to put it there or on this back wall. Right here, today I worked on getting some of these shelves in. Again, pallets, almost everything in here is free pallets. Shelf there, shelf there. I also put another stud here, and I'm going to be working on putting these tiles right here and having a little vent here for the hood I'm going to be putting right here. So I'll have my stovetop here and the hood with the exhaust going out this way. I did the same kind of thing here on this side, and I'm going to fill it up with insulation, and, you know, I'm not sure what I'm going to do as far as putting something here. I may have dishes hanging or something. I also got a little more of the cabinets done, nothing really to look at. I need to finish up part of the roof in order to do the cabinets, so kind of waiting on that, but it's coming along really nice. I'm really happy with the progress, and I'll talk to you guys soon. See you.